So hello everyone and welcome to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more important questions from the PIB news which are important for the ESI section of RBI Grade B. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon for daily updates about the videos. Alright, so let's begin with the very first question. Consider the following statements regarding Northeastern Region Power System Improvement Project and identify the incorrect statement. So you have to consider these statements regarding this project and then identify the incorrect statement. So first of all, the question is why this project is in news, because this project guys was launched in the year 2014. Let me tell you this, this project was launched in the year 2014 and it is being funded by World Bank. It is being funded by World Bank and the Government of India. So why it is in news? So it is in news because recently the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved rupees 6,700 crores funding for this project. Okay. And as I told you, this project was launched in the year 2014 and its objective is the total economic development of the Northeastern region and to strengthen the intrastate transmission and distribution network in the Northeastern area. And of course, this system guys is about power system improvement project, which means यहाँ पे हम बात कर रहे हैं किसकी, electricity की. So basically इसमें क्या होता है, grids बनाए जाएंगे और grids के through पूरे northeastern area को connect किया जाएगा. Okay, and ministry of course is the ministry of power. Ministry of power इसको implement कर रहा है and the launch year, it was launched in the year 2014 and it is targeted to be commissioned by the year 2021. 2021 तक इसको commission करने का target है. Its implementing agency is Power Grid, of course. And which are the beneficiary states? So remember, six states from the northeastern region are the beneficiary states, which are Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, and Tripura. Okay. And funding, as I told you guys, that this scheme is funding is being funded by the World Bank and the Government of India on a 50-50 basis. But remember, the capacity building component. Okay, the capacity building of component of rupees 89 crore is being funded totally by the central government, or you can say the government of India. Okay. So I hope guys this scheme is clear. This project is clear. This project guys is all about developing the power system project, power system of the northeastern region. And remember, only six states in the northeastern region are the beneficiaries. Implementing agency is Power Grid. And of course, the ministry is what? The Ministry of Power. All right. So let's come back to the question now. So we have to identify the incorrect statement. So first statement is, it is being implemented by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So is that Ministry of New and Renewable Energy? No, that's Ministry of Power, which means this statement is incorrect. It was launched in 2014. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And it is being funded by Asian Development Bank. That is not Asian Development Bank, that is World Bank. Okay, so therefore this statement is also incorrect and we have to find the incorrect statement, which means option A, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 2. With which international bank, Government of India has signed a loan agreement worth $400 million to provide social assistance to the poor affected by the pandemics. Guys, this bank, let me give you a hint. This bank already has already provided $750 million loan for the same purpose, for supporting the poor and the deprived who are affected by the pandemic. Unke liye already ye bank $750 million ka loan provide kara chuka hai and this is the second tranche of this type of loan. Okay, and remember, this bank is what? Option C, World Bank, and this loan is of worth $400 million. Okay, remember the loan amount also. Pehle kitna diya tha? $750 million. Now it is $400 million. Okay, so World Bank and Government of India have signed an agreement of worth $400 million to support the poor and deprived households who are affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. All right. So therefore, guys, the correct answer should be what? Option C, World Bank. World Bank president is David Malpass. As we all know, David Malpass is the World Bank's president. Asian Development Bank, it's Masatsugu Asakawa. Masatsugu Asakawa is the Asian Development Bank president. Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, it's Jin Liken. Then we have New Development Bank, it's Marcus Prado Troijo, and finally European Central Bank, it's Christine Lagarde. Okay, and now guys, let's move on to question number 3. So question number 3 and 4 are the most important question because these are based on the United Nations Human Development Index, which is most important index if we talk about our exam. So let's talk about the index first. So United Nations Development Program. United Nations Development Program has released this Human Development Index. And let's talk first about the index. So guys, this index, the first edition was released in the year 1990 by Mehboob Ul Haq. It was created by Mehboob Ul Haq, the Pakistani economist. Okay, it was created by Mehboob Ul Haq, and the first edition was launched in the year, was released in the year 1990, and it is based on the three key indicators of health, education and standard of living. Okay, so it is based on the three key indicators of health, education and standard of living. Health is measured by life expectancy at birth. Life expectancy at birth se measure hota hai. Education hota hai measure mean years of schooling and expected years of schooling se. And standard of living is measured by the gross national income per capita income, you can say. So these are some basic facts about the Human Development Index. I hope ye to aapko pata hoga. And now let's talk about the 2020 edition. 2020 jo abhi recently Human Development Index hai uski baat karte hain. So total countries kitni li hai isme? 189. There are total countries which have been taken in the index, 189. And there is a new metric this time. Okay, that's very important. For the first time, United Nations Development Program introduced a new metric to reflect the impact caused by each country's carbon emission. Jo har country ka jo carbon emission per capita hai, uska development ke upar kya asar aayega, is naye metric ko include kiya gaya hai is baar. Okay, so it is for the first time that a new metric has been included in the index, which is what? That is to reflect the impact caused by each country's per capita carbon emission on the development. Okay, and these are the ranking. Norway is number 1, Ireland is number 2, Switzerland is number 3, and hamara pyara Bharat is at 131 rank. Okay, in total there were 189 country, and India is at 131 with a score of 0.645, and it is under the category of medium development. Okay, it is under the category of medium development. Okay, and talking more about the rankings, so if you talk about the rankings of BRICS countries, so Brazil is at 84, then we have Russia 52, China 85, and South Africa 114. So among the BRICS countries also, India is at the bottom at the place of 131. And agar hum pure world ke score ki baat karte hain, if you talk about the score of complete world, whole world, then it is 0.737. So you just have to remember the overall score, that is 0.737, and India's score, that is 0.645. okay. And talking specifically about India, guys, so India has medium human development, as I told you, with a score of 0.645. And India's score has increased from 0.429 in the year 1919, when the first edition was released. It was 0.429 to 0.645 to this year, and there is an increase of how much? 50.3%. And talking about life expectancy at birth, so according to this report, India has the life expectancy at birth, how much? 69.7 years. Expected years of schooling in India, it is 12.2 years, while GNI per capita is how much? $6,681. Okay, so that is some specific information about India. So isse zyada aapko is index mein padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. That is more than enough. And now let's come back to question number 3 and 4. Consider the following statements regarding this index 2020 and identify the correct statement. So here you have to identify the correct statement. Now let's talk about the statement 1. Ireland has been ranked number 1. So is that Ireland? No, that's Norway, which means the statement is incorrect. Overall SDI score of world is 0.737. yes, this is absolutely correct. As I told you, you have to remember the overall SDI score of the world and of the India. India has been ranked at 131. yes, this is also correct, which means we have two statements correct here, which are second and third. Therefore option B, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. And question number 4 is also based on the index. So we have to consider some statements again regarding this index data of India. Okay, this question talks specifically about India. Okay, and we have to identify the incorrect statements here. So India has medium human development index. Yes, this is absolutely correct. India has a score of 0.645. this is also correct. And life expectancy at birth in India, it is 69.7 years. So according to this HDI 2020, this third statement is also, guys, absolutely correct, which means we have all statements which are correct. Therefore guys, option D, none is incorrect, will be the correct answer, because we have to identify the incorrect statements. And now let's move on to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Who has been appointed as the Vice President of Asia Pacific Broadcasting Union? So this union, there is a union which was established in the year 1964, and an Indian has been appointed as its vice president. So let's talk about this. So let me tell you the answer first. The answer is what? Mr. Shashi Shekhar Vempati, who is the CEO of Prasar Bharati. Okay, he is the CEO of Prasar Bharati. He has been appointed as the vice president of Asia Pacific Broadcasting Union. And as I told you, this union was established in the year 1964 as a non-profit, non-governmental and non-political organization to assist the development of broadcasting in the region of Asia Pacific. Okay, aur iske current president kaun hai? Mr. Ibrahim Erin. And remember, the ABU's board of directors is also the administrative council. So which is the administrative council? The ABU's board of directors is also its administrative council. So iske bare mein aapko bhai itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. And remember, Mr. Shashi Shekhar Vempati has been appointed as the vice president of Asia Pacific Broadcasting Union. All right, so therefore the correct answer is what? Option A. And that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.